All-Star Weekend.
Yeah.
Effing vodka.
Yeah, man.
What's up? What's up?
Yeah, the hottest niggas in the street, the realest niggas in the street is in here. I mean, right now.
It's going down.
You heard the last song, man. Nigga.
Yeah. New York City.
Hot.
Yeah. All-Star Weekend.
Effing vodka is up here. Yeah. We're getting nice to this right here, Phil.
Yeah, man. It's all good, man. It's we taking over, baby.
Yeah, man.
It's Effing vodka. No more puffy juice.
Oh, man.
Now we do it.
And the event yesterday was amazing.
Yeah, we had a good time, man. Everybody was out there.
Super packed. No, your police left everybody alone.
Yeah, they ain't bothering nobody. That's how it surprised me in New York.
That's really crazy because they've been harassing rappers all week.
No, I bet you it don't be no problems this whole All-Star weekend.
What? You think so?
Yeah. I bet
everybody
you.
Everybody trying to kick
Cause
you,
Because they're chilling. Like, you know, don't fuck with them now. You know, NYPD, go on your little... Don't fuck with them now. Even the mayor know what time it is.
Put them to the test.
Don't put them to the test now.
They're going to try some new shit on you.
NYPD, if you're on your ass.
Y'all niggas is crazy up here.
That's true.
It's like down there, you know, we dealing with that shit from the police and shit.
For real, but
up here, y'all going through the same thing, you know what I'm saying? So
it's a little different, man.
It's a lot of money, man. You're going to get a special beat down this weekend.
I put my money on everything. I bet everything. The strongest gang in New York City is the NYPD. Now, Trump.
Hey, you know, I was shocked that the hip-hop police is still around. They were in front of the spot yesterday. Like,
yeah, I seen them. Every time they come places where I'm like, hey, what's up, Joey?
How you doing, Billy?
Yeah, you see them like that. Yeah, see y'all.
Shout to Curly Top, man.
Oh, my God.
Curly Top, you see that nigga at every club. I remember it was the band for a while. It was like, no G-Unit, no nothing when you come through, man.
Get the fuck
out of here.
That nigga Curly Top, man.
I seen one of them niggas that locked my ass up out there. I'm like, yeah, motherfucker, I told you I was going to get out one day, motherfucker. Straight.
Yeah, I ain't never been in no trouble since they've been running around like that.
That's crazy, man. Once again, FM Vodka, real quick. It started in January. That's when you started the launch?
Yeah, well, I just really officially signed a deal recently.
Okay.
That's why, I started talking about it a little bit. But it's organic. You know what I'm saying? It's just...
It has to be organic because people have been bothering you for years to promote.
To try and, be a part of liquor companies. And I didn't do it. And then this one came right around. It's the Bean Group. And it's the right thing for me at this point.
And, of course, the whole crew is going to be
Can I roll up it?
Yeah.
Because everybody's hot right. Everybody's super hot right now.
Black cherries. I like the black cherries.
Well,
that's the best one I think.
We got a few flavors already. Dutch.
I ain't tried this one yet.
Dutch raspberry.
You tried all them shits.
Yeah, I ain't tried the front like anything. Yeah.
Whatever's there, you... Man.
Keep going, Joey.
Nigga, Ye done tried the shit that ain't even out yet. Talk about that. How long, Ye?
That shit wasn't even. Yeah,
Ye know the shit that's about to come out.
I probably did drink this one.
Oh, my God. Shout out to everybody tuned in, man. You know, the number one question is they want to know what order was the reunion. Like, who was the first to come in, and when did you decide to get everybody together? Everybody know y'all back, but how
was. It was really like Buck reached out, but it took for everybody to fall out for me to look at it a little different.
Okay.
For, because I'm looking at it and I got my moral compass, my system that I function on is from my neighborhood. So, if they do something a certain way, I respond by not dealing with them.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, because they're my brothers, like, I don't actually react by doing nothing. I just... Don't do nothing.
So it's not music. It's not like business. It's just like more personal.
Yeah. It's just all that. And it's my personal expectations of them at the same time. I expect them to be bigger.
Because it was crazy because Banks was MIA. Yale was fucking going crazy, right?
Yeah, he's retarded.
And I was going lunatic mode.
Oh, well, calling me retarded. Yeah. This is the biggest bully right here, ladies and gentlemen. It's my brother right here. But this nigga been a bully since 10 years old.
Look at this.
This is not new, Fifth.
I'm starting to hear that more and more, though. Fifth. I ain't going to lie, Fifth. I'm hearing more and more niggas be like, yo,
big
Buck.
Homie.
Yo, like, for real, the nigga been bullying niggas since we was kids and shit. Like,
yo, who kid? When this nigga come outside to the block, niggas used to be like, all right, here come Boo Boo. Oh, man.
See ya.
This nigga's going to do something.
Now, tell the truth.
You make two niggas fight, you end up fights.
No, I like it.
You used to terrorize everybody. Come on,
if they want to fight, you gotta let them fight. They're already gonna do it anyway.
Yo, you're crazy, man.
It's not right. Like you think you're gonna change the world? You think you're gonna change the world?
This guy
yourself?
Been a bully since 8 years old. Man. Don't let him fuck you.
He tried. Look, he tried to deflect the shit. He tried to deflect it by saying that. Yeah. They tried to deflect the shit.
I was smoking beer.
Yeah.
Oh my God! But when Banks came in the picture, was it the death of Chris Lighty? Did this one y'all first like seen each other?
Yeah, I seen him, but that wasn't it.
Yeah, that wasn't it.
Banks, that wasn't it.
No.
Banks
is like,
Thanks.
I expected him.
To be honest, I felt uncomfortable even talking. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Talking right
respect for Chris Lighty. You know what I'm saying?
Wow. Rest in peace to Chris too, man. Yeah. I never got a chance to see Chris, you know, after my separation. But I always wanted to, you know, get back around Chris. Like, I never had any situations with a lot of dudes that was around the camp.
Mm-hmm.
I never, even when I look back, even on me and 50 and all of us, it was never beef. It was just a real big misunderstanding.
Yeah.
So, you know, in my eyes. Anyway.
You know what you can see that's different?
Yeah.
You ever heard somebody say I didn't pay him? Ever.
You know that's
no, they got overpaid.
Yeah, yo, you know
everybody
what?
Got overpaid
for real. Cause even when you know when the people was like, "Yo, Buck broke and shit," my broke is your rich.
There's $1 million still at $1 million.
See, I'm at $1 million and I'm like, damn, I'm broke in the motherfucker.
Yeah, and you looking at
straight
like,
up
like broke.
So motherfuckers like, "Yo, Buck broke." I'm like, damn, I need to go spend some of this shit, but I couldn't.
They got to sit still.
And I had to sit still.
You know, and chill, because I mean, if it ain't rolling in the same way it was rolling in before, you stop. You don't move.
You better sit your ass
down.
Oh,
you a damn fool. You know what I'm saying? If you got,
then I'll be broke for real. Then I'll be out there for real, like you motherfuckers wanted me to be.
Yeah.
For real.
But can you admit, Fifth, it was the last of the Mohicans? Like, he stayed the longest, right?
No,
he's going to tell me.
Somebody gonna say that line.
Can I question you right quick? Who can?
I was in Long Island.
Does it feel about? Hey, who can? How does it feel being on the radio with your brothers and knowing that the world is tuned in and like, yo, them dudes is right now fucking the world up.
Hell yeah.
How does it fucking feel, bro?
Serious,
man. No, ask me this. Ask me how.
Hey, yo, 50.
How you sat there and was like, yo, I'm saying, but you got so much of it.
Oh, shit.
He talking about money. He wants money. Like, I'm saying, but you got so much of it. So fucking
no
what?
Money from you,
did you
man.
Not see me Come get on, up man. And go to work for it? He sat there like, here goes his kid. He go, yo. I want to open a restaurant.
So here goes the bully.
What you know about opening a restaurant?
Here goes the bully tactics.
What the fuck you mean you want to open a restaurant?
It's the bully tactics. I should have came at you with a business plan. But
he's just going to come randomly and say, I want to open a restaurant.
So you know what I did? I went and got smart. I figured this shit out. What I did was went and got me a restaurant.
Yeah.
Before. I said, no, I'm not even going to ask to do
at
this
the
shit.
End of
I'm
going
to buy me
let
some
shit. Let me ask
shit.
You a question.
Word.
Can
and
I
then
ask,
I'll come back and holler at this
nigga. Tell him what's at, boy.
Let me ask you a question.
Tell him what's at. You got to tell him the location.
Oh, yeah, straight up. I'm in Cashville. Food for the Soul, Clarksville Highway. You know, shout out to everybody who done stopped through. And we open right now. You understand? So if you tuned in and you in Cashville, stop through 3101 Clarksville Highway, man. I got what you want, man. Y'all know how my menu is. Look at my Instagram, man. I don't play. When you see me pushing that line and showing you that menu, that's
listen,
really
yeah,
my
and
menu.
And then
listen,
yeah,
this, is
up
what,
one day.
This is what I'm telling you.
Go ahead.
All right, picture this. We all from the hood.
Mm-hmm.
Southside, 134 got Brewer. Me, Banks, Yayo, he's from Neville, right?
Yeah.
As well as Kid, he's from NO, right?
Yeah.
Now, we didn't have anything. He had stuff already. He had Benzes and all that already. He was
but
going,
I come from nothing.
Listen, and I come from nothing too. And I hear you. We had nothing, right?
And then you seeing all this
I'm on Rikers Island. He shot 1.4 million in like 2-3 days, nigga. I'm in shock, nigga. Like, yo, I gotta get the fuck out of here, my nigga. Speaking he come see me in jail with rings as big as I never seen rings this big in my life, bro. That's the last thing I seen. And then I come home and niggas put me in condos and shit like that. I went a little crazy. Sometimes this shit can drive you crazy.
That's why you call
every rapper that just start, what do? They get their rapper starter key. The watch, the chain, a couple of cars, a couple of houses, a lot of bitches. That's a part of the starter kit. And start looking good. Right?
Man. Except for you, Ye, with the girls.
All right.
That part.
We no comment to that.
Yeah.
No comment. Here we go to bullying again.
Speaking of money being made, Banks was like touring continuously during that time. So
Banks, old rich ass.
You kept busy.
You know how Banks like to just save his money. He's just rich.
Go ahead, Banks.
The quietest, richest nigga I've ever seen in my life.
My passport got 3 books in that shit.
Yeah, that shit is serious, right?
You know, that all came from the beginning, though. I was fortunate enough to get that run, in front of all those people doing 50, 60,000 people. You know what I'm saying? 10 years ago.
Shout out to Phil. And the hip hop,
definitely. The hip hop that was going on at that time, it ain't too many movements. Like, you might see a Wu-Tang shirt. You know what I'm saying? G-Unit.
Still out there, yeah.
But you don't see the new movements. The motherfuckers don't make it to Kosovo and
the Wu big going over there. Like that. They
don't know what they're talking about.
They just not going to Dubai. Yo, niggas is going to Dubai this year. Last year.
I mean, yo, that's funny.
Hey, yo, you know what? You know what? Let me bring some. Say, I didn't mean to cut you off. But I be seeing a lot of these cats, right? And this Instagram shit is amazing to me. Before I went to prison.
Man, Instagram was around when I was stupid.
There you go. Instagram, like I watch these dudes now, like a lot of these dudes, the life and shit, you know, that they live and it's cool. They put it out there. I do the same damn thing. Mm-hmm. I can't act like I don't. But, you know, Instagram wasn't there 10 years ago. See, we've been balling for a long time. A lot of the shit that these young dudes is doing, man, this shit is old us. You understand? Mm-hmm. And it's like, I know a lot of these dudes tend to lose respect for their elders behind the life that they're living now, but sometimes they feel realized, nigga.
I'm not an elder.
I don't write your back hurt, but nigga, I feel like I'm 29.
We did a 2-hour show
I'm some of you niggas elders, and I want to be some of you niggas elders.
I'm trying
to give some of you niggas some
education. My shit hurt, nigga.
Nigga, my shoulder's cracking, my shit fucked up right now.
Listen, my back doesn't hurt.
The shit that I used to do years ago, jumping off the stage, I ain't gonna lie, I still do it. I do it a little bit better now.
I ain't getting no older, nigga.
I'm getting younger, nigga. And I'm not playing with this rap shit. I feel like we're underdogs.
What up, kid? I ain't say you couldn't do it. Still do it. But
I just feel like, you know.
Yeah, listen, my back don't hurt.
Now or never, niggas.
You need to go to chiropractor. Look at this look. I'm getting older. I'm getting older like everybody else is. But my back ain't hurting at all because I've been to the chiropractor. I just give you some advice.
Oh, man. How is it that you guys are back now that you guys are on tour? How's the feel?
We ain't really hit a tour yet.
I had a lot of fun, though. We went through shows back to back, though. That's what he's saying. We was in Maryland, then we did Philly.
Yeah.
And it felt like we got more fun after the first show, right?
Yeah, we're about to roll, I'm sure.
It's better.
Yeah, it does.
It's starting to get better, and I'm working the kinks out like as you actually go, you know, because you get a chance to kind of feel out what's effective and what's not. And then you want everybody to be themselves on the stage, so you want to kind of make it a show that everyone feels comfortable with at the same time, then instead of doing what I would do for my own show.
And Kid Kid being the fifth member, how's that interaction?
Kid Kid fits in perfect.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He's like the missing piece of the puzzle type shit.
Yeah, man.
Come on, man. You know I'm loving it. Me, who cares? You've been on that road, man. It's crazy, man.
Magnolia.
I love this guy's accent. You got to say Maizan, man. You can't say Magnolia like that. You know, that's uptown. You know, I'm
from downtown.
You're dead.
Hey, hold up, don't care. You know, I'm a Cashville uptown. They so shout out to uptown and the downtown.
Shout out to uptown. Shout out to my dogs, all 3rd and G. You already know, man. The muscle.
So Lloyd Banks, man, a lot of people are attacking you. Like, you know, they want to hear, is going to be new music now? That, you know, the next project is what? The Beast.
Yeah, The Beast will be out.
Yeah, The Beast.
The Beast is out.
And that's the 23rd.
No. Before The Beast is out.
Well,
Before the Beast. Buck tape Before The Beast.
It's out right now. Go get it.
Yeah. You can download it right now.
Up. The Beast, the EP.
Who kid?
That's March 3rd, right?
Yeah, the EP is coming out. March 3rd.
You can pre-order that now.
Yeah.
The Beast is G Unit, the B.I. Monster Third, me and Who Kid.
Yeah.
Killed them real quick. The streets is fucked up right now.
You following that.
Before the beat.
Yeah. Nah, but that. So you might die for this? Lose your life for this?
Yeah.
That shit crazy.
That's that shit.
Kick him. You ain't stupid on that. You ain't
and again,
stupid on that.
Even with this mixtape
right here. Nah, for real. Stop for a second. Stop for a second. Listen, I want you to go back. Listen to Kid Kid part. On the G Unit records. Every record that he rapped on. Every single record that he rapped on.
Shit.
He showed up. On each one of them joints, man. Like it's for like sure. When I see a comment from a guy like you know, the fans will say, oh, why is he there? Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? You ain't hear this shit?
Yo, that is crazy.
You know what I'm saying? Like they're going, you know what they resist to anything that they don't know. Like anything that's new is you know, like,
It's going to be even more plain to see, though, because consistency.
Yeah, you see him changing, like, even though, on now, that record. Because I see a lot of people like, yo, that nigga went in on that. Like, niggas is recognizing
they
now.
They're changing their mind. Yeah.
In the beginning, I know what you're saying, but now,
it's like, no different. I look at it almost like me. Like, when I first came amongst the unit, you know, it was amongst the time you was, you know,
yeah,
when
it was
you
good.
Was locked
it was good.
Up.
Because of your complexion. They didn't even miss this nigga.
Yo, Phil, you crazy.
Nah, but Yayo went to jail, and Buck was like, they was like, Yayo, it was good to tell Yayo.
And Buck thought I was Yayo.
Yeah.
That shit crazy,
bro. They used to think I was crazy, you serious, my nigga. Yeah. I used to come out on the stage, my nigga. I used to go in the back after the show. I used to be like, yo, Phil. These motherfuckers not finna keep calling me Yayo. You know what I'm saying? He used to be like, nah, man, just chill. They gonna get it, bro. They gonna get it. It's gonna be all right, dog. Yo, literally, dog, I would come out and motherfuckers would be like, Yayo, yeah. And then when I come up, and then these motherfuckers see who I am. And then they be like, no, but this nigga bumping, though.
Yeah.
So it's how I almost ride with Kid Kid. It's like, it's the difference because they, of course, know he's not
right.
But it's like I think he had to grow. You know, the standards is set so high over here in G-Unit. You got fucking 50. Mm. You got Banks. You got me. You got Ye. The standards is set so high from a fan perspective, I think they looking at it as like, motherfucker gonna have to be as good as them niggas or better than them niggas. You know what I'm saying? Anybody who come over through here, like, type shit.
Yeah.
And then when people realize, yo, this nigga's good, nah, this nigga might be a little bit better than me, then it changes, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I look at him as a rookie and vet, because he was signed already.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And he still was spitting balls on the last label he was on, but now he was Fifth, and he's seeing more. Word. That's one thing about Fifth, man. We go through where we go. This man flew me around the world, bro. We've been to Dubai. We've been to Germany. We've been to Paris. We've been to Russia. We've been to Africa, Amsterdam.
Is there anywhere left?
Nobody can ever take
Alaska,
that away from
I don't
me.
Think I've never been.
We've been doing this for a long time, man.
50 shot a movie
a
out
long
there.
Time.
Yeah,
long
yeah.
Time. I remember Kid Kid first time overseas.
We did Iraq, nigga. Remember that shit?
Kid Kid, you remember that?
I remember, nigga.
We went to Greenland, nigga. It don't even get dark outside, nigga. Y'all, what about that shit?
Yo, hold on.
We was in Iraq. Let me tell you a story, right? As soon as we get there, right?
Wait. You gotta. Getting there, nigga. The fucking plane.
Getting shot
The plane.
You had to put helmets, vests, all that kind of shit just to get over the shit.
Yeah, and as soon as we got off the plane, like, because we had to ride in a military plane.
Yeah.
To we was performing for the soldiers.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, the plane was dipping and diving, and we had the hooks and shit, like, we had to hang on in the plane. And then when we got there,
I think PR old ass was there.
Yeah, the guy came to the, like,
seen his old ass.
The military officer came to the plane. He said, listen, I'm not going to bullshit you. You could die today.
Yeah.
I said, what?
What?
I said, yeah, you did, nigga.
I said, what the fuck did I sign up for? Like, this is the shit that, wait a minute. I thought we was just doing an extra show on the day off.
They got to go straight and go straight down because they can't fly over the war zone.
Wow. Yeah, that's why he said the plane, the reason why the plane was going up and down is because we got friendly fire.
Yeah, friendly fire.
That's crazy. He
said, I said, what?
Then we get to the spot. Nigga said, nah, we cool. We only had one missile. We got one missile today. It's been calm. What, nigga? Missile landed over here?
How about when 50 performed with a gangster and then the soldiers were shooting and up in the air? I was like,
what about Jamaica? Y'all forgetting Kingston,
Jamaica,
man.
Yeah, they went nuts.
Listen, man, that's one of the realest places. A lot of rappers pop shit.
Yeah.
And it's cool. But see, Jamaica is almost like a testing ground. Mm-hmm. And it's not a lot of rap artists that's from here that can even that walk the streets of Kingston.
That was crazy.
So for us and the things that we experienced
Africa
in Kingston
too.
And Africa.
Now, Africa is hoodie.
It's crazy.
When you fly to Angola, nigga, that shit is west of the jungle, motherfucker, nigga. You in the jungle, nigga. Africa is real, boy.
Come on, who cares?
Hey, yo, who cares?
That's racist.
Hey, yo,
I've been warning you. That was
shit.
Crazy. Where'd that come from?
There you go with
nah,
that
you going
shit.
To Africa.
Nah, yo, man, see?
You African niggas
so
going to fuck
about Africans,
you up,
I don't know what that nigga's about.
Like India.
Nah, but the shit that's crazy. Somebody died in Jamaica, and we still had to do the concert.
Word.
Yeah, yeah.
Because Mike Lighty was like,
nah, nah, somebody, they got loose. Yeah. And then we had to come back. Right. We came back from the, we was at the hotel. I didn't leave the hotel yet. I didn't leave the hotel yet. Right. So by the time that happened, Mike, they was calling back saying, yo, you know, something happened at the venue, but it ain't stopped the show. So everybody's still,
yo, we been
still
mad,
doing
man.
It. So I'm like, is the show still, everybody's still doing their sets, like performing? He said, yeah. I said, then I'm doing my show then. I don't care if they, you know, like, is that really for, they it's a little more rowdy. Like, they, you know, they make blow torches out of shit. Like,
yo,
they spray with the lighter.
Them niggas, yo, they lit the whole fucking mountain up with this
you know,
shit.
Yeah. Let me tell you something. Me and Banks, right? The way the show was set up, we had to come out before Fifth, the way Fifth had the thing set up. Uh-huh. So it was like, boom, me and Banks run and hit the stage.
Hold
right?
on, hold on. What show?
In Kingston.
All right.
Yo, as soon as we hit the stage, one thing I learned is that when these Jamaicans holler, pop, 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 with their hand in the gun shit, it's only because they don't got that motherfucker in their hand. But yeah, there you go. That shit right there, right? But when they got that motherfucker in their hand and they fuck with you,
yeah,
they gonna let that bitch off. So when we came out on the stage, all you seen was them goddamn tarantulas going to hell. Bop, 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 bop. And I'm thinking, God damn, Lord, please don't let this nigga get mad and turn that bitch this way. You know what I'm saying?
I think
they respect us. Yeah. Just see niggas that could stand through some shit like that.
Right.
And let niggas know that, look, man, we come from that environment. I ain't gonna lie. I come from that environment, but not quite that fucking crazy.
That's why.
But I'm like, hey, nigga, I'm here, nigga. Y'all niggas kill me. It's
niggas
cool. I died
that stage when
in
that
Jamaica. Bury me by Bob motherfucking Marley. That's I looked like, at it that way.
That's why I wanted to ask 50. I know nobody never asked you this. Why is there like no fear factor on stage when there's like shooting? We've seen like a lot of violent shit when we perform.
Yo, honestly, that's why I got it. That's why I don't got that shit, no. Because I used to watch him do shit like.
Bro, we seen like outrageous shit.
Yo, he's been,
shit.
Yeah. Been doing that from
it didn't
early.
Matter. Listen, man, nigga could have got hurt.
Nothing
bro.
Stops the
you
show.
You didn't carry
yo,
out.
Yo, 50, you don't matter. Ain't nothing gonna stop the show.
That's the first thing he ever told me. I don't care if there's one person there, yeah, yo. Or 10,000.
The money
don't
was
stop
there.
The show. We gonna do it.
No, right. I said perform
from
the show,
beginning.
Explain
it's Columbia say, days.
Perform the show the way we practiced it.
Right.
So don't lose your energy or be unenthusiastic about the situation because it's not a lot of people there. Because even if it's five people in the crowd, we want to turn five or four people into fans.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It's not like...
And they going to tell somebody.
Right.
That's one of the jewels you told me a long time ago.
You got to think like that.
Columbia.
From the very beginning because you're not going to always be in a sold out venue and it's not going to always be a situation that feels ideal. You know what I'm saying?
Every promoter ain't the man.
Yeah, Phil, right. But I don't
you
think...
You got niggas do their first... They promoters, rookies. They might try with you.
And hey, they go, they put you in, like... It may not even be, like you're saying, it may not even be the mistake of the artist.
Yeah,
it may just be set up wrong.
Yeah.
Right.
And you get there and not everyone comes. And you for you to go on or to not to go on stage and misrepresent who you are as an artist is terrible.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I think, you know, it's your job as an artist.
I don't think it's no
to
shit you can
that way.
It's no shit you can teach us or tell us to get through that shit. Yeah. Like at that festival in the Redneck shit.
Yeah. Yo.
Y'all remember that shit?
First of all, hold on.
Do y'all remember that shit?
Them niggas was throwing bottles before we went on stage.
Hey, yo, that was the illest shit I ever
seen.
Them
shits
was
backstage.
Was real. I knew shit was
it
real.
It was fucking football players throwing shit, man.
I looked up in the fucking air and I seen a fucking 10-speed flying up.
Look
to the stage.
No, wait. You're going too far. Look what the nigga 50 told us, though. Nah, it's cool. It's like, that's what they do out here.
Yeah.
So we like, that's what they do out here. He's like, it's like a ritual and
he's
shit.
Like, it's cool. It's a ritual.
Yeah, them shits is coming too rapid.
And
so I'm like,
yo,
I don't know.
Now
we come out to the whoa intro.
my shit a Walt intro.
Because like, I love, man, yeah, I love that record, the Walt shit. That was like Black Mob record.
He's crazy.
Walt was, yo, let me tell you. Who kid was trying to DJ?
I got four records. I got four records. It was like my favorite hip hop records. Because they had a moment that was so visible for me. Like I felt them so differently away from everything else that was going on. Right. It was like Busta Rhymes, Put Your Hands Where My Eyes Can See. He was the first one. Then you had the what's the name record had a moment. Black Rob's Whoa.
Yeah, Whoa was serious.
Had a record because the song, the whole song was a chorus.
Yep. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that one was crazy, like the way they chanted. Like the crowd sung the song instead of him.
Like
and
Whoa.
It, yeah, and then the other joint was, what's the name? It was Lean Back.
Yeah, Lean Back. We did that.
Lean Back had a fucking minute. It was a moment that record. Yeah,
crazy.
Lean Back, and it was one of a joint. It was one of a joint that was I was crazy about that I had, and I was like, damn, that shit is stupid. But I couldn't even like me and Joe was arguing at the time, so I couldn't say it. I was like, man, fuck that nigga. But I liked it. I loved the director the whole time.
But the final question, like the answer we need right here. This is a scenario. A guy comes out with an AK, shoots at the crowd. Why is it you don't stop the show? Like, what goes on?
So he's not shooting at me.
Right. I learned that. That's some real shit.
Can you explain?
As long as he's not shooting at us, bro, 50. Keep it moving. Let's keep going.
Let me explain it to you. We did a show.
I love that shit.
I think we was near War. It wasn't Warrior. It was somewhere else that was
Africa.
Crazy.
Yeah, he started shooting.
Somewhere else
in
Africa. And Fifth jumped off stage. Whoever this political guy was, I don't know who he was.
Yeah, the militant.
He was somebody. But 50 jumped off the stage. People started jumping in the crowd. Running.
Now, what happened is that we was in a soccer field.
Mm-hmm. Right, yeah.
Everybody is behind the actual gate, like where fans would regularly be watching the game. They didn't actually pay to be as much as the people who paid to be in the chairs that were on the actual grass. So they started shooting because the people run through the gate onto the grass, like trying to get closer to the show. So when that's happening, really what you got is they're losing order of the people in the venue, and their police got a different level of aggression, so they're firing a weapon.
Different level? They'll smoke you.
Listen, let's say they identify with being shot a lot better than other people. The probability of you being shot is higher in that situation. So they may identify with me in a different way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then when they decide they're going to run too, they're like, fuck it, I'm running over there. I want to see 50 Cent.
And you've never stopped any show. I've seen outrageous shit. You've never once stopped shit.
Yo, listen, a nigga threw
Blackouts, shootouts.
His personal guitar at this nigga.
Yeah.
A whole guitar on stage.
You know what?
That time that they started throwing bottles and shit at us, look at this. It was a festival. Everybody was there for so long. It was a total rock and roll festival.
They wrote shit on
we was the only rap group big enough at the time to be in that venue. Like, we're selling 13 million records now.
Yeah.
Yep. You know, so it's a full rock and roll festival, and we come on, and they had threw bottles and shit at the groups ahead of us.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, yo, this is the shit that they doing here. So I said, yo, put the bottles on the front of the stage.
And we threw them back.
We threw back though. We ain't going for the stage because they throwing the shit. I don't give a fuck.
Most of the
shit was landing in the pit anyway.
Buck got hit with a bag of shit. He went crazy.
And I went fucking nuts.
Yo,
that's all the truth. I went fucking nuts.
A bag of shit.
Yes, I did. And I went fucking nuts. And I don't want to say what the fuck happened after that because, you know,
ride his chest. You know,
I'm on paper and shit. I'm still on parole.
Once it got dark, the lights crazy. In you so you couldn't see it, you know.
I went fucking nuts, man.
Well, we're going to get into life, man.
Remember me out there, bro.
We're going to come right back, man.
Play some fucking music. The streets want to hear this shit. Who cares?
Yeah, I'm getting into Kid Kid, Yayo. Young Buck, man, before the beast.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. We'll be right
back. This is my joint right here.
Don't question us dropped out of charges.
Charges?
Yeah, for real.
And this ghost is looking gorgeous.
You know what, 50?
I think I might just set this bitch on
forges. Shout out to Forges, man.
One time for my old homie, he died behind that gold.
Go rolling.
Took two times for them broke bitches, been acting like they don't know me. Yes, I am the new wave with these black shades and my new J's.
And I got the unit sitting back on top like toupees.
I like all my pussy pants.
I eat all my pussy.
Pretty
patient. I sell my dope regardless. Back getting money with 50, but I still feel.
feel like I'm starving. Y'all know what I'm charging. Bitch, don't start all that arguing. And just cause you see this phantom don't mean I still ain't robbing. Hey, what's up, Harlem? Back on my Brooklyn bullshit.
Hey, yo, run that back. Run that back. Hey, yo, what's up, Harlem?
Don't question me about that.
Hey, yo, that's that shit.
Wanna do something for me?
Before the beast, you know what this is, Mike?
Might order me a few bottles, bring it to me with the sparkles. A couple partners just came home, just dropped out of charges.
Charges?
Yeah. And this ghost is looking gorgeous.
Thank you, 50. Thank you for the ghost.
I might just set this bitch on fortress. One time for my old homie, he died behind that gold.
Go rolling.
Two times for them broke bitches, been acting like they don't know me. Yes, I am the new wave with these black shades and my new J's. And I got the unit sitting back on top like toupee. I like all my pussy pain.
I eat all my pussy shame.
I'ma sell my dope regardless. Ain't getting money with 50, but I still feel like I'm starving. Y'all know what I'm charging. Bitch, don't start all that arguing. And just cause you see this phantom don't mean I still ain't
robbing.
Hey, what's up, Harlem? Back on my Brooklyn bullshit. And I'm crossing Queensbridge with a white brick and a full clip. Forges with two big lips. I'll set my fat bowleg.
Yeah.
My bitch don't need no makeup and my picture don't need no edit. Come on. I just been going ratchet. Right. Fuck a rapper, I rap that back. I can't buy no kid with plastic. I ain't worried about paying no taxes. Now, look, I just need a stove.
You're crazy.
So where to dump my ashes.
Yeah.
Hey, yo, boy. Hey, yo, boy. Do you know how many gangsters lost their life for this?
Life for this? I got partners lost their life for this. My homeboy doing
life for this.
You know how many gangsters lost their life for this?
I know killers took his
life for this. Yo, Busters.
Life for this.
Forensics make the truth come to light.
Come to light.
Blue star spray, see the blood in dark light. That gave my homie 25 to life.
Yeah.
Plus the DNA on the scene matches life.
Yeah.
They dudes lost their life for this.
Yeah.
Over small shit, you can get your ass up, my new.
Ducking demons
in my sleep. I'm dreaming. About the mirrors and model freaks. Come on.
Water whipping by the stove.
Work.
In the
rest in peace, Eric Gardner.
Holy
shirt.
Yeah.
Two bricks of dope, table full of
wax paper, traffic in the trap, a nigga finally made it.
Life for this,
two units in the building.
They life for this, my nigga boy doing life for this.
Kid Lloyd Bench, general for this shit. Life for this,
life for this.
Lost their life for this.
What?
I got partners lost their life for this. Units in the
building. Yeah. Doing life for
drinking
this.
That epic
rock. Life for this.
All-Star Wicked. Kid Kid, you ready? Let's go, Kid Kid.
For this.
Man, this shit too real. Too much beef. I need
two grills.
Can't be swinging at you. I'm banging at you. I'm
too lil.
Get your mama killed or a dollar bill. Just cut and dice. You know how I feel. Strap up and walk back up. You know how it is.
What's happening, nigga?
Nobody move, don't make a sound. Get your daughter drowned.
Friends go out to Bobby Brown.
You think I got time to take it all for this? You know how many guns I got
off for this?
Stop this! Stop it! The new kid is ready!
He's ready. He's ready.
That shit is... Kid Kid is ready.
Kid Kid, night four.
Do not play with... You hear the nigga verse?
He more than ready.
Put shit back.
He got off on that
one. Said, prayers go up to Bobby Brown.
Tell me what the spark
unit, nigga.
A couple partners just came home, just dropped out of charges.
On the charges.
And this ghost is looking
gorgeous.
Gorgeous. I think I might just set this bitch on
Forges. Shout to Forges on IG.
One time for my old homie, he died behind
me. Hey, you go, Forges, y'all better send my rims.
Like they don't know.
Come on.
Yes, I am the new wave with these black shades and my new J's. And I got the unit sitting back on top like two bays. I like all my pussy paid. I eat all my pussy
shades.
I'ma sell my dope regardless. Yeah. Back getting money with 50, but I still feel like I'm
starving.
Come on.
Y'all know what I'm talking about. Bitch, don't start all that.
No,
see the phantom
don't mean I still ain't robbing.
Hey, what's up,
Harlem?
Back on my Brooklyn bullshit.
Yeah, and I'm crossing Queensbridge
with a white brick and a full clip.
My forces with 2-inch lips.
Come on.
My bet, Bole.
My bitch don't need no makeup.
My bitch don't need no edit.
Ratchet.
I rap
that plastic. I can't buy no key with plastic. So I ain't worried about paying no taxes. What? Look, I just need a stove. And somewhere to dump my ashes.
Time to cook, baby.
Every time
before the beat, young buck, let's go.
Life for this. I got this doing life for this. My homeboy doing life for this.
Rest in peace to them gangsters in Southside all over, man.
Life for this.
Everybody locked up.
Show life for this.
Forensics make the truth come to light.
Come to light.
Blue star spray, see the blood in dark light.
Yeah.
That got my homie 25 to life.
Yeah.
And the DNA on the scene match the type.
Yeah.
Gangsters paid their dues, lost their life for this.
Life for
over
this.
Small shit, you can get your ass hit.
Yeah.
Ducking demons in my sleep.
In my sleep.
I'm sky dweller dreaming about the mirrors and model freaks.
Oh, yeah.
Water whipping by the stove.
What?
Work
yeah.
In the eye, can't breathe. Fuck police shirt.
Eric guards the rest of the
dope. Table full of wax paper.
Yeah.
Traffic in the trap. A nigga finally made
do you
it.
Know how many gangsters lost their life for this?
Life for this.
Bullets looking like for this. My homeboy doing
before the
life for
up
this.
Now.
Lost their life for this.
Get it right now.
Life for this.
You might
lose your life for this.
They life for this.
Yeah.
Lost they life for this.
My homeboy doing life for this. They life for this.
Kid, kid, knife, world.
Man, this shit too real. Too much beef. I need
two grills.
Can't be swinging at you. I'm banging at you.
I'm too lil.
Get your mama killed on a dollar bill. Just crap and dice. You know how I feel. Walk back up. You know how it is. Lay it down. Nobody move.
Make a sound.
Get your daughter crown. Press go out to Bobby
Brown.
You think I got time to take a loss for this?
This?
You know how many guns I done bought
for this?
I ain't coming in all for this. I work all for this.
Bring it down now.
For this. She used to play hard to get. Now hard to miss.
Oh, my God.
She gonna tell me all for this. We ain't got all for this.
Yeah.
Just so he kept old for 48. My niggas ain't tall for this.
And he ain't lying. He ain't lying.
Life for this.
Yeah. Hey, life for this.
My homeboy
the
doing life for this.
Free
Chucky, man. I know the streets
life
like.
For this.
I know the streets like, man. These niggas is fucking shit up.
Yeah.
For real.
That shit crazy.
Right there. Nigga, yeah. We here, man. We
new
out here, man.
Yeah, the U.S. should have done
it, man. Big
yeah.
Like, yo, man.
Big body beans. Big body beans.
Big body
beans.
Big body beers,
what?
Big body beers?
Hey, hey,
come on.
Killers don't have no
conscience.
Won't they go about it?
Yeah.
Up in the
mouses, rats.
They Mickey
Mouses.
Get up in the trousers.
Came
in and gave me a slap. Say she found all that
crack under her couch.
Come on.
I can't sleep, friend.
Google in my dreams.
All niggas on machine. All y'all
work for me.
And I'd rather work a triple beam
than that Burger King.
Rob you for your
bling bling.
Give me all your
ching ching.
Flip your pocket from your jeans. Make sure I
get everything
before I leave.
That's a bitch.
And we just having a fling.
Right
again. Like a phone.
Answer it when it ring.
Let it ring
till it click.
Hit me clip. You can smell me.
When you say I've been through some shit.
With my click, him zone.
Right again. The dick
is because of street fame. Bitches know what it is. They gon' say I'm doing my thing.
Now what's up?
No. What's a big body beans? Big body beans. Big body beans. All I ever wanted was a big body beans. Big body beans and a clean set of rims. All I ever wanted was a big body beans. Big body beans. Big body beans. All I ever wanted was a big body beans. Big body beans. Clean set of rims. Pussy cocky bought them Regals in them Bondi fields. Then they got them red bone bitches. I'm like this for real. Me, I want that big Benz with that emblem in the grill. Stop packing the steel, letting niggas know the deal. I want that shit so bad, start thinking who I got to kill. What nigga feel when we out there in the field? The rock was pumping, paper coming, how can niggas chill? Barrel link, man, it's go teeper, go to let my
grill.
Shoot that shit on myself, I use it as a shield. Look at the wheels, look at the wheels. Chrome two piece Lorenzo's got me looking like a meal. Peep card, if you wanna talk, then later we can feel. On it was a big body beer. Big body beer, big body beer. All I ever wanted was a big body beer. Big body beer, and a clean set of reels. All I ever wanted was a big body beer. Big body beers, big body beers. All I ever wanted was a big body beers. Big body beers and a clean set of rims.
Sitting back in my new
AMG,
smoking whip 2003. Blow they rip 2
pieces. Supreme,
smoking whip 2003. Holding zinc, now up with 2B. Four sold out my D.
Oh,
you need to be at 2B. Focus through my new designer lens. Shout out now her friends. Buku Dallas, man.
New designer again.
Too cool time and win. I'm on top again. She gon' top me
all. Ruin bitch.
No risk, no reward. Peace talk won't go nowhere. Gets ignored. My price is being informed. Lightning at your core. Get you more. Right here like before. Seen it all. My life should end like this. Come that filthy rich. Still not guilty, bitch.
All I ever wanted was that big body beers. Big body beers. Big body beers. All I ever wanted was that big body beers. Big body beers. And a clean set of ribs. All I ever wanted was that big body beers. Big body beers. Big body beers. All I ever wanted was a big body beers. Big body beers. And a clean set of ribs.
Hey, yo, bro. Hey.
The
unit. I can
hey.
Feel
hey.
Me.
Hey.
Got the hey. Nigga 50 up here. Wow.
Hey.
Boy.
Hey.
We got
hey.
The nigga 50.
Hey.
Wow.
Hey.
Watching,
come on.
Look how I'm moving. Hey, yo, you know I got that All-Star Weekend voice right now.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? So we just going to watch.
Hold up now.
Y'all see them, man. They watching us,
finale
man.
Last night was a movie.
Yeah. Hey, yo, y'all
they
know
definitely
I,
was
we
watching.
Got that live performance voice.
I got 50 in these streets yeah. going crazy.
Yeah.
Give
me every bottle in this bitch. Yeah.
Hey, yo. I yeah. got 50 out here in these streets going crazy.
Yeah.
We might pop up at your party, people.
Come shit. On.
Uh-oh.
Pop up at your shit.
New York City.
Uh-oh.
All-Star yeah. Weekend. Yeah. Uh-huh. F and Vodka. Let's go.
Kill a kill. Chill and chill. Get a feel. Really real. Cashville.
Club Live. Shout out to Cashville. Shout out to the Ville.
Come on.
Cashville.
Same old two step. And a few lifts. They got two lifts. Hey, guess what? G Unit.
Go. Go.
Look how I'm moving.
Look how I'm moving, nigga.
Watching me.
Watching me.
Look
what I'm doing.
Hold up now.
They watching me. Mm.
I keep
we
it moving.
Up here, man. We partying right now, man.
Hey, yo, yo. It's feeling right. Hey, yo, who can? It just feel right. Who can?
I think I love these hoes, a nigga tryna fuck them all.
Yeah.
Ballin' out with blood, boy. No suckers in my section, no, 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 my shit legit. You niggas get the flexin', bitch, and I will get you hit.
I
got a paper about a nigga getting plenty bread. Or it's the perpetual, you niggas know what time it is. Stands like a B-boy, juice like a D-boy. Yeah, I'm a G-boy, you know it's me, boy.
I think I'm gon' remain reclining count. So many
yeah.
girls, they take an hour for me, shout them out. Big Coopin' Farrens, this shit I hit been super boring.
Hey, dog.
I'm sharp as honeys with the blue fin on them. She the phenomenon, I kept my promise. Respect and honest, yeah. the ground before for neck of diamonds. Plenty shot, don't got the time. And Biddy out there, Allen hopping, and yo, I'm still in the thousands.
Bottles of Clico smoking hookah with eight hoes.
Oh, yeah.
Five angel heads on my neck, all froze. Intervisions, interpretations, watch with your ears.
Yeah.
I bought the last watch in the league.
Yeah.
Ass Jacob Ass, David Ass, Eric DeJula.
Hey,
ass Beth
hey,
in Jersey when I bought my first Mueller.
Uh-huh.
I got him watching me with that Yacht Master Rolly on and that new Rolls Royce with the top. Go!
Hey, yo, 50.
Yeah!
Yo, this nigga, yeah, yo.
We got a word,
he says man. Kid. Shout out to Banks. But this nigga, yeah, yo. I got to
yo,
give
I'm,
him.
I'm with the best niggas in the game.
We got to give this nigga
work, man.
His props, bro. This nigga's been going fucking crazy.
Hey,
can
you say some shit lately? Can you play? Can I get
what's
one
that,
request,
right,
kid?
What's that right there?
Can I get? Can I hear that Ruga wrote the new shit off Before the Beast? I gotta hear that one, man.
To get to it.
You hey, gotta
yo,
get to that
hey,
one.
Yo, David.
Yeah, I'm just as real as you. I just got out of prison
too.
Hey, money
y'all,
you
see all these goddamn chains on my neck?
I got all my ice, and I'm turned up.
Y'all should see all this goddamn ice on my neck right now. I swear to God, I am so fucking icy in this bitch right now. Y'all should see me right now. Like, I am not fucking playing. Straight up. This bitch can't fold. Hey, fuck you stank hoes. I've been thumbing through them bands, boy. Unloading trucks, really, you wouldn't understand, boy. I'm the boss, I'm the man, I'm the landlord. These niggas try to count me out, but now they paying for it.
I've been counting up why they was counting me out.
Yeah.
Fuck them.
Yeah.
I've been counting up why they was counting me out.
Fuck them.
Yeah.
No, hey, yo.
Shut up,
get that check.
Real.
Get that check.
We
get
here
that check,
now, nigga.
I've been counting up why they was counting me out.
Here, nigga.
Yeah.
Shout out to all the NBA players out here that's balling.
This is my part right here, though. This is my favorite part right here.
Flexing on these niggas. Y'all know niggas flexing on me. I'm flexing, y'all. Flexing on these niggas. Hey, and I'm rolling, rolling, rolling.
Hey,
what up, Big U?
Yeah. Man, we need some. When did it turn this into a party?
Why not? Why not?
Yo, why y'all do? You're doing the show the wrong way.
We're doing the show wrong.
Hey! Yeah, that's new dance. Hey. I got a new dance.
Hey!
Who can dance? My shit called the rich nigga.
Oh, yeah.
That's the rich nigga?
Hey, that's the rich nigga. Hey, yo, look at him. Hey, yo, this the rich nigga right here.
Do the rich nigga, fam.
Do the rich nigga.
Do the rich nigga. Do the rich nigga. Do the rich nigga. Do the rich nigga. Yeah, I like that.
Do the rich nigga. Do the rich nigga. Hey, yo. We're going to the store. We're going to the store.
Damn, no, about that. Damn, no, not about that.
We are going to the store.
Turn up, turn up, turn down for what?
Banks, you did this a long time ago, Banks.
Said the rich
oh,
yeah, they gotta see my dance. My dance is called the rich nigga.
Go ahead, fam.
Shout out to them GS9 boy, Bobby Smurda. Yeah. Hold your head, my
free
head.
Free
Bobby Smurda. Like I'm crushing these shows. $100 shoestrings. Now I'm busting these souls.
Look in my eyes, see clouds.
I'm puffing them up.
Come on.
I need
a couple of those.
Yeah. Yeah. Chick when I want, pal, punching with the rhymes.
Tell your girl we said what's up. That's the boy, yeah, but that would be. I gotta show you the beat. You gotta wait till the right beat. Come on.
We got the radio station wilding up to the big right now.
Laughing to the bank tomorrow.
I'm trying to tell you. And yo, we really popping bottles. We really doing this shit up here, y'all. And I am really icy than a motherfucker up here, y'all. Y'all should see how my fucking neck look, y'all.
Icy for All Star Weekend, man. And drinking that effing, man. Right?
Yeah,
we're going to the jewel after this.
We leaving here. We're going straight to the jewel.
We ain't far from the district. Hey, yo, Eunice in the building.
Make sure you got my presidential words together. Make sure my shit is VVS, dog. 50 is right
yo,
here, Fip, my nigga.
I got to see that dance.
Make sure my shit is icy, see. David. I'm on
my
way.
I'm trying to tell you. The rich nigga.
Oh, shit, the rich nigga dance?
Hey, yo, that's Patton.
What's the nigga? That's my nigga, right?
Yeah,
the one
that's
out.
It, yeah.
Oh, shit.
That's your song.
Nigga, you rich on it. You want to see me rich on it?
This is shit right here for
the rich nigga dance. Then I tell you, I put my collar up on these hoes.
The rich nigga dance, we going to the studio, Phil.
They don't want to fuck around with me. I'm trying to tell you right now.
We're going to do that.
Rich nigga dance. You see, this is shit you do when you rich. You don't give a fuck. You don't even find the beat. You just go.
Hey, yo.
Fuck you gonna tell me, man? Hey, I make. You see what kind of money I make selling underwears? Frigo, nigga.
Oh, shit.
Frigo. Can you say Frigo?
Money, man.
I really don't even like the girl. I put the girl in that shit because you done heard she be around me.
Nigga.
You understand me?
You feel me?
It's Valentine's Day. I'm confused.
I love you, baby.
I don't even know where I'm supposed to be right now.
Yeah.
Rich nigga dance.
I'm married to the money, baby. Happy Valentine's Day to you, baby, but I'm married to the money, boo-boo.
Yeah.
See, you gotta do, all you gotta do is think this, right? You gotta think you're running, but like in slow motion, like, because these hoes, they be on the niggas, so you got to run from them.
That's the money dance, right?
Yeah, you be like, come
that's
on,
the rich nigga.
Baby, I'm running from you. You want commitment, you want love, you want heart shaped chocolate candies and bears and flowers today.
And so you gotta run.
I can't do it, that's what I'm doing. So, rich nigga, I'm running.
We gon' need proof. We be two stepping, Mr. Yeah, F with the juice. Me, I know just what to do to get them loose. Me, I know just what to do to get them loose.
It's
early, but we drinking.
Yeah, it's early, but we got a nice shoes.
I was just stunned, man. This bitch ain't confused. Me, I know just what to do to get them loose. Me, I know just what to do to get them loose. Loose.
Fuck you know by busting down a brick, nigga. Yeah. Always think that you around a bitch. Picked up and pack and I ain't looked back since 96. Since then I've been addicted to designer shit.
Okay.
Chopper in the parking lot, I'm trying to find a lick.
Yeah.
Come up on 1,000 pounds, that's my kind of rich. Independent, I don't need no nigga with me. I do everything quickly, don't believe me, ass bitch. Yeah. I got game for these hoes, can't no broke bitch trick me. Ain't can fit 100 bands in these
what
navy blue
so? Come on.
What up, girl?
Bruce, yeah.
Fuck with me.
Bitches saying I'm the truth.
Fuck with me.
I know just what to do to get them loose. Get
fuck with me.
What's up, bottoms to my booth?
Fuck with me, nigga.
Bottoms to my booth.
Can you
please bring my bottles to my booth?
I know just what to do to
get them loose.
What up?
Can you please bring my bottles to my booth?
I brought our bottles to the booth.
Light it up.
Bottles in the air. Fuck them niggas.
Get some money.
Louis the 13th, I drink rich nigga shit. Turn one into two quick. I do tricks with the brick. Extra clip on my hip.
On my niggas with the shit.
It's the unit in this bitch. I'm 50 rich now. Who you with?
Shit, you mad.
Nigga don't wanna pop no bottle.
Yeah,
yo, keep saying, nigga, what's $1,000?
Hey, yo, check this out, though.
She must don't plan on staying if she don't
show. I'm about to go get this Rolex and some real shit. I want my shit icy, man. David, this shit is real,
yo,
man.
This was like a party up here, 50. What the fuck happened?
This shit is for real.
The bottles is pumped. It should be a party. We should be in like a party environment.
Nah, it's all star weekend. It's only right.
Only thing we gotta change this place up,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, kid, you don't have any, hit the moisture button? You don't have any?
Of course.
I mean, this all star weekend.
Hit it again. Usually you have... Usually you have moisture up here. Got a lot of goons up here.
If we had naked bitches up here, we wouldn't be able to do the interview. Yo, 50, real quick, Frigo, shout that out, man. You got a new underwear line? What's up?
Frigo. It's in Neiman Marcus right now. Y'all see it in Bergdorf's. They come in, it's moving around. You know, it's high end for men. You know, you can go in Victoria's Secret. Valentine's Day, you should be in Victoria's Secret right now, right? All men should be in Victoria's Secret right now, even if that ain't your thing, because you should be buying something for her. It's for you, fool. That's when you buy something, buy a nice lingerie, and say, baby, go put this on. Put this on. For you, for Valentine's Day. You understand me?
Yeah.
Well, you gave us a gift already because the SMS audio headphones all over the studio finally. We've been waiting for that shit.
Yeah, we sent it finally.
Everybody got a pair.
Look at this beat up ass Sony headphones on the top of this. God damn.
Damn, them shit was in the 90s. Them shit still look ancient up there.
92.
Yeah,
them shit.
They got the beats, though. They got these shits.
Yeah, How we looking for SMS headphones? New colors, new designs. What's up?
Yeah, man, all new stuff, all new technology too.
The ones
you can see right now, we got the Bio Sport.
Carmelo joints.
Yeah, the Carmelo Anthony. Those are the sports has additions right there.
And the wireless.
But we got the Bio Sport joint that is like a wearable. It tells you your heart rate, how long you've been running.
Yeah.
Oh wow.
It tells you your.
Some of these rappers need to get one of them.
Yeah, the distance and the pace that you've been running is compatible with Runkeeper, and it's battery charged itself. So, right. You know, it's good. We work with Intel on that project. So, you know, we got a chance to work with bigger technology companies. Since Beats merged with Apple, you know, their competitors have been really good to SMS. So it's cool. We got deals with Disney. We make all Disney products inside theme parks and everything we do. Got a deal with the Lucasfilms.
Oh, Lucasfilms.
Star Wars. So what? We played the Star Wars edition of SMS Audio. See, y'all check it out. We all over the place with that. Yeah, I'm in 62 countries with SMS Audio.
That's wow. And make it clear that this is competitive. This is not beef with Dre. You want to make that clear?
It's not even a competition.
Yeah, it's like
they were so far ahead of me when I came.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That, you know, it was cool, but I knew what was going to happen to the people that came behind Dre.
Mm.
You remember Diddy Beats?
Oh, yeah.
Remember Gaga Beats? Mm-hmm. Justin Bieber Beats? What happened? Okay, I didn't want to be one of those. You see what I'm saying? They got phased out immediately after.
Yeah.
And just the core brand, they went back to the core brand and kept the whole brand cool. But they just used those people to put the cool on it.
But people confused because of your background. They always think that because when you come out with a product, you're going at somebody's beef.
Yeah, they think it's a beef all the time. I really don't care. You know what I'm saying? Like,
okay.
I really don't care about that. You know what I'm saying? Like, even if it compromises our relationship,
yeah,
then it wasn't really a relationship the way I feel about it. And then maybe I should have let him get punched in the head at the war show.
Oh, man.
You know what I'm saying? That's the way I feel about it. You know what I mean? I think when you get ready to go into these different things, like Russell Simmons didn't tell me I couldn't sell Urban Clothing after Fat Farm.
Wow.
Following that, you seen Rockaway, Sean John, G-Unit, you seen Nelly Crew, even Apple Bottoms.
Mm.
You've seen so much other urban brands follow that you shouldn't even feel like it's a competition. It's actually a compliment. It's showing you this new category. Why would you not have passion for selling music when music has done everything for your life?
Wow, that's crazy.
You know, or being a part of music culture, when you've seen that music itself isn't selling the way it used to sell, you want to be a part of how people consume it.
Believe that.
But you seeing the future of how music is moving, that's why you decided to be independent?
Right. Like, I can care less about that.
Mm.
What you could do for me at this point?
Wow.
What label could do for me?
Yeah. You want to show people my face?
Yeah, like, I show people my face. My own like,
faces, yeah, like, you can't do that again.
What you want to do? I really don't even have to do an interview. Why am I doing an interview?
Uh-huh.
I got 38 million people on Facebook.
Yeah, that's the real
that
shit
is true.
Right there. It's kind of crazy.
I stay home. I don't have to talk to you. These people, I tell them what I'm thinking or creatively what I'm doing next right from my phone.
Wow.
If that's the case. You know what I'm saying? I don't think that all of it drives it. Like I don't want to tell them with Chief Keef in scope. I told him don't even let him do the interviews. Don't leave him alone.
Mm.
It's not his thing. Like, he wasn't supposed to be talking at that point.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, he's shy time. When I thought Chief Keef is what hip-hop is. It's pure.
Organic.
It's what Bobby Shmurda, too. That's the same shit.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It's somebody coming out the environment that's influenced by the environment.
Right.
And they're just going to give you that. That's what they know.
And this next EP coming out March 3rd, what's going to be the difference from this one and the next? Is seven joints again?
Yeah. These is harder. Yeah. It's harder. It's way harder than the first one. We didn't shoot everything off the first one, so we're going to shoot all of the stuff that you hear on this record and off of the beauty.
You see
videos for all of them coming out shortly after. So we're going to work now.
On Instagram, they've been catching you with a lot of the artists out there. Is that for this project or your album? Or I see you with like Tyga.
Tyga and Chris.
Chris Brown and all
that. That was for my record. I'm trying to finish it now because I pushed it back for, like, me and Chris had did a song already.
Right. Mm.
But I felt like we could do something that felt like right now, like that was new.
Mm. So you got that in the stash. And then
we went back in and worked. So we got a few songs together.
Wow. For real?
Yeah.
Shit, man. Shout out to E-40 who loves you. He just tweeted me.
Yo, you know what?
E-40.
I got
a
joint,
man.
I got a joint from him.
Yeah, crazy.
We getting ready to do something right now.
E-40. That's the big homie right there.
40
Yo, that's some crazy ass shit, man.
Yo, you know what I'm fucking with real tough from 40 Water?
Yeah.
Choices. You know, I grew up on 40. 40 is like one of my favorites.
Shit.
You understand what I'm saying? And if you really pay attention to 40, you know, your game can get all the way together. I tell a lot of cats that, man, you got a record, man, that's called Choices that's out right now. That motherfucker's moving.
I'm getting ready to do that, John.
Yeah, that's crazy.
That shit is like that. Fuck with Fonny Water. Fonny Water, what up, big homie? As you should.
And you don't.
Sick of death.
You shout out, you don't give a fuck, like the Empire thing. You know, I've seen the marketing, and I'm like, yo, is it me or is this power? Like, what's going on here?
Yeah,
explain
that. They copied it, but... You know,
is it an NBC thing? Do you think that because they
no,
own...
it's Fox.
Mm, Fox. Okay.
Fox Network. But you know what? Look, if they see something that's successful, they'll kind of stay in that vein. It's the cookie cutter mentality. Mm. I don't think it was personal. I think they just copied it. But I got a lot of friends on that project.
Okay.
I got Terrence Howard Day, who was in the first film that I Get Rich or Die Trying.
Mm-hmm.
I got Timbaland is the music supervisor over there. So, you know, I do business with Timbaland behind the scenes.
Oh, wow.
A lot. So, you know, he's a good friend of mine.
And Taraji's sexy and a motherfucker.
Well, she was. Man, she kind of went in on it.
She had a little attitude.
Yeah, what happened, though? What
I don't care. I can fix that.
Go ahead, Phil.
You know, I'm like 9 inches.
Nah, I like that shit.
Yo, this nigga
I will
crazy.
Fix that shit.
Straight up. That's what I'm saying. Like, this motherfuckers like, yo, she went in a little bit. What? Come here, baby. You got attitude, baby.
I got girth.
Straight up.
Thick.
Bring your fine ass here.
I will calm my ass down.
Come here. I got something for you. And if he can't calm you down, baby.
That was so left field. That was like for Taraji. That was kind of left field. But whatever.
Nah, it was cool. Yeah. I think it was in fun. I think she thought I would respond nasty towards her. But I like Taraji.
Straight up.
Yeah, so I like her work. I always watch her show. Ever since I seen Baby Boy. She been eyeing with me, man. That's right. You know I'm going outside and I'm going to do some shit, Jody. That's right. I'm Jody.
Yeah, she was
I'm going to do some shit. But I just don't have that dope. Problem with mommy, baby.
She dope. Even in Hustle and Flow, Jody's dope, man.
I give up, man. So, you got Spy and South, what is it? South Porth Movies.
Yeah. Shout I got out. The Spy movie will be out in May. It's me, Melissa McCarthy.
Wow.
Jude Law, Jason Statham. It's a dope comedy, it's action comedy, it's just really good. Melissa McCarthy is your usual suspect with a hit comedy right now.
Wow.
She's back to back like that. And then Southpaw, you catch me, Jake Gyllenhaal, and it's me, Jake Gyllenhaal, directed by Antoine Fuqua.
Okay.
And Forrest Whitaker.
Get the fuck out of here.
Crazy.
It's Forrest, my favorite act, one of my favorite actors, man.
Is his eyes always like everywhere? I feel like one eye is looking this way.
Did he not just hear me say that was one of my favorite people?
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'll fuck you up.
I'm sorry.
Look at me. Reef coming in smiling, right?
Hey, there go your man. What up, gangsta?
That's the goddamn dog.
Reef did what up, gangsta? And they never did another hot one yet.
Yo. I think this nigga
what
got
up,
something blood? In the stash, dog.
What up, Kyle?
Yo, Robbie, I know this nigga got Robbie, some shit.
He's still getting checks
did
up there.
Really did you really make that beat, man? Reese, did you really make that beat, man?
Yo, Reese. You need two bandanas, man.
Yo, Reese rich as hell off of that one.
With two bandanas, nigga, I'm still getting money off this shit.
Yo, listen. I'm sure Reef don't care if he get fired.
Hey, yo, what's in there? Is some chicken in there? What's in that?
Who shit is that?
We got, get we, some of that shit,
we got some final questions, 50. A lot of Twitter fans are wondering because
y'all know who it is.
Earl Hayes died, and then you kind of like tweeted him and RIP'd him. Are you and Floyd cool now, or is still whatever?
I don't care what Floyd doing.
Yeah,
that's my baby brother, man. That's my little brother, man. I don't care what he doing. He do whatever he want to do.
Okay.
And man, and he's a champion of the world. Can't nobody beat him. What you want to say? It's pretty tough to tell somebody what to do. He kick ass for a living. You see what I'm saying? So
that's about right.
When he kick ass for a living, he's going to run. He's going to live the way he want to live. He's going to spend the money. He's going to do what he want.
And you being a boxing expert, the Pacquiao thing, you feel it's too late or is
I'm not sure. I don't think it's happening.
Okay.
I don't think it's happening, to be honest. I think Floyd will beat him. If they fight, you know what I'm saying? I think he could have beat him 2 years ago, 3 years ago. You know what I'm saying? I just, when he don't take the fight, it makes me feel funny about it. You know what I'm saying? Like when I don't see the fight actually happen, it makes me feel like why he don't take the fight. He might know something personally that I don't know about it. I know ain't nothing the matter with Manny Pacquiao. Don't think because that Marquez lost anything different. Ain't nothing matter with his lateral movement. He's sharp. So it would be the fight that everybody looking to see.
Speaking of assimilating, the way hip hop is now, are you guys in shell shock or y'all just trying to figure out skinny jeans?
I ain't
hip-hop
trying to figure
shit.
Out shit.
You just doing you.
I'm ready to bring back real regular fitting clothes.
Straight up. I'm not trying to figure out or fit in me personally. What's I'm on shit? Some more do me shit.
It's a regular.
I'm bringing it back, baby. We're gonna wear clothes that fit you for real, like regular fit. It fits you for regular.
You didn't go to Kanye West's fashion show? Yeah, like
nah, man. And whatever your jeans. Is against your ankle. Something's not right.
Straight up. We just gonna keep it. We gonna keep it regular.
If your sweatpants gets tight as it gets to the bottom, something's not right.
Yeah, we're gonna just keep it regular, man. Just keep it regular, bro. If your fucking thighs is thicker than your fucking old ladies,
if
man.
You tuck in your fucking jeans in your shoes.
Man. Like if your
you
fucking
tuck your
legs
fucking
nigga,
jean in your fucking shoe.
Your fucking legs is fucking thicker than your girl's shit, bro. Fuck, man.
Yo, listen, listen.
Yo.
This is not proper representation of me as a business person.
Yeah.
This is me hanging out as a rapper.
Yeah. You ain't never lied.
This is my public service announcement.
I tell you, I'm the one that's influencing him to do all this crazy ass shit.
That's a good look right there.
Hey, yeah. you know what I really like to see, though? Hmm. I'd like to see that check from Epic. How they didn't get Bobby out?
Free Bobby Smurda, man.
Why they didn't bail Bobby out?
Damn. Roddy Rebel, man.
He's still locked up. I thought he came out.
He never got bailed out.
They were supposed to have a bail hearing like months back.
What's the deal with his situation?
He's still in there.
Shot money in the man, bail him out.
Oh, man. Here we go.
Free Bobby Smurda.
How your name gonna be
Rebel,
money
man?
And you don't show up with the money when the niggas go to jail?
Come over here, man. Kick it.
I can't save you, who kid?
Yo, I'm good.
Yo, I like to make them uncomfortable. the whole room.
I don't get uncomfortable, personally.
Yo, Fifth, when Banks got locked up, how fast did you get him up?
I bailed all of them out for me.
Straight up.
I got out fast as shit, though.
I'm waiting to shoot somebody because I know.
Don't say that. Don't say that.
I know. Rules are different in the NO. For real. When you get the fuck up for real.
Yo, kick it.
Niggas think it's a game. I'm waiting on a nigga to fuck up for real.
Yo.
Hey, yo, no bullshit.
Niggas talk too much shit, real niggas.
No
shit.
Bullshit.
Drink
I would,
that effing, man.
I went to jail. Hey, yo, who kid? Uh-huh. I went to jail, right? Me, Bank, Olives went to jail, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to tell you, man, we was in there probably, this how quick we was in there maybe just to do the paperwork. We was, maybe took maybe roughly an hour and a half, but within that hour and a half, I caught a charge in jail.
Get out of here.
Within a fucking hour and a half in jail, I catch a fucking charge in jail, man. Who does that?
What's happening? You want the clear one?
Like on some real life shit, like in jail, right?
That was when y'all had a gun charge, right? Come from Madison Square
Straight
Garden.
Straight up. Leaving Madison Square
and you know,
Garden.
You know what security do.
And I catch
that
a fucking attempted murder charge in
Every
jail.
Time you get in the car with a security guard, that nigga be like, that gun ain't mine. Gun be under another nigga's seat. You gotta be careful when a nigga get in your car with a gun.
Shout out to the motherfuckers who got that check out of me in jail. You got your ass whooped for that check, nigga. And you got a life sentence, so you'll never see the streets again. So I hope you gave that check to your family. Man, I caught a fucking charge in jail out here. I was in that bitch for like an hour and caught a fucking charge and end up having to settle.
Yo, cameraman, drink some effing, man. Drink some effing. Get a cameraman some effing, man.
Vinny, is it hard to get away from the streets with your business?
Ron, drink some of that, man.
The way you run shit and you're like very high up there, is it hard to leave the streets?
No, it's not hard at all.
Okay.
You know, it's a lot of things to occupy yourself with. I'm learning a lot of new things.
Okay.
You know, so I'm away from, I'm not sitting in the middle of that.
Because people see you with Merrill Street walling out and then they see other things and...
Right. I mean, I could do a lot. I could be in the middle of... I could be with Meryl Streak and I could be in the neighborhood.
That is crazy.
Like, at the same time. There's no difference. But, you know, it's because I'm from a different part. Like, I come from there. So everybody knows they can communicate with me on whatever level. I hate that I get the guy at points that comes and goes, yo, what's up? Yo, put me on. Mm-hmm. And he don't have nothing prepared.
Right.
To be put on. Like, put if you was talking to somebody else, like if he was approaching Jimmy Iovine or somebody else who was in a position to give him the deal, he'd have a package, a presentation or something. But they'll go, yo, what's up, my nigga? Yo, put me on. And I look at him like, if you don't get the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
Because you come in and shit, you ain't got nothing. You saying, look at me, like, yo, just put me on.
Put you on to what?
On for what?
Put your ass on that goddamn subway down there. Straight up, put your ass on the subway, tell your ass look.
Yeah.
Motherfucker, pay attention. Like, I pay attention to talent, man. I go through it a lot. We all do, bro. And we pay attention. I don't even want people, some people may take it as if, like, you know, Fifth is like, nah, shit,
if
no.
If you that talented, can't nobody fucking
Straight
stop
up, man. And if you come correct, then, you know, you're going to get respect. You come with disrespect, you're going to get disrespect.
That's where a lot of the problems come from, because you get guys that come around and they really come around because they want to be somebody. They want to be a star or something. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And they look at it like, you could just make me a star. Mm-hmm. You could do it. You know what I mean? Because they look at me like I made Banks a star. I made Yayo a star because we're from the neighborhood. But 50 did that.
Right. 50 provided the opportunity.
Yes, opportunity. They did everything that they did on their own. They did all their own work, their own merit. So it's like, I didn't do that for them. Mm.
Yeah, we wear that a lot, bro. Yeah, you know, a lot of people may get this shit twisted over here. And I need to go ahead and make sure I get this clear. You know, 50 is the big brother. But 50 don't hold no fucking hands over here, bro. We our own man. You know, honestly, man, I work for every fucking thing I got. And I'll say this around 50, bro. I ain't asked 50 for shit. Y'all see this shit I'm doing out here, bro? It's because I feel like this, bro. He's done his job when it come to us. So I get out here and I grind just as hard. I don't need no fucking handout. I don't need nothing from you. Yeah, you richer than a motherfucker. I am too, Phil. You know what I'm saying?
No,
thank you, Phil. You gave me the opportunity. The only thing I need from you is that support like you do. You know, but financially coming to a 50 with my handout, I felt like I've done that before. I learned my lesson from it. See, I was the one that bumped my head. I really jumped off the porch, come from nothing. I was used to putting the bread in the paper bag, like for real. So when I got the experience of having money and able to spend it legally, I went crazy, bro. And a lot of people, you know, tend to get it like, yo, Fifth did this or Fifth did that. No, I never had a money problem with this dude ever in my life.
But they got more than the money they were supposed to get.
You know what's crazy when you say that? I remember a long time ago when my album first dropped, and I was in MTV, and I was with Hervé. Rest in peace to Hervé. This is like one of the hardest working men in the business.
Yeah, rest in peace, bro.
You know what I mean? He worked. He was close to Banks.
Yeah.
When I came home, Buck, Fifth, like, it's like family to us. You know what I'm saying? Rest in peace to him. And we was in MTV, and I remember Young Guns was there. And he said, and I was like, yo, I like what I did on my sales, but I feel like I want to do more. You know what I mean? He was like, don't worry about it, man. You got 50. You see these guys right here? Jay don't do shit for them. You know what I'm saying? And I realized that, like, in the industry, everybody ain't going to hold your hand through shit. Somebody going to just... Fifth do a lot of favors for his heat. Wow. You know what I'm saying? Like, even when I look at the Kid situation, he took him and brought him straight overseas.
That's
the way you're supposed to do it. You're not supposed to bring an artist on unless you go on... actually groom the artist. Mm. And then I say, like, I take Buck he didn't come to be around me until he could be paid to be around me.
Word.
Right.
Like, I knew I liked his music. I knew the whole it was cool. Like, I was like, yo, I wanna work with him. But it wasn't until I could actually pay him. If you have respect for the person, you don't ask a grown man to come with you somewhere for nothing.
I still remember the words you said to me to this very day, man. Phil said some shit to me like, yo, I don't believe in asking another man to starve. Meaning, like, I'm not going to ask you to come work for nothing. I'm going to get you. If you're going to work, you're going to be paid. So from the beginning of my career, you know, through the Rock the Mic tour and even Banks, like, we were getting paid and he was in the forefront. So at the end of the Rock the Mic tour, say, that's, you know how many years ago, right? That was.
Like 10 years,
10 years ago. At the end of that tour, I was a millionaire.
Right.
Like, I had $1 million before I even thought of putting a record out.
And then the thing
you
is, nobody
what I'm
really,
saying? I'm being 100 with you.
The only thing that don't come with instructions is money.
Right.
That's and when you got it, you come and say, how much I got? I got $1 million now. What? Because you got paid every show.
Yeah. Right.
But there wasn't, we didn't have any time to spend the money.
Right. Mm. But when like I realized person, I had $1 million.
That's like a person that right now is working, is getting $30,000 a year.
Right.
They can survive over the $30,000 a year because they got 8 hours a day that they're being occupied. Mm. If you gave them the idle time throughout the day with that $30,000,
they'd be in leisure shopping, all kinds
of shit. They'd be hit. They'd be hit because they'd be going places and spending additional money, traveling, and it'd be like, yo, I ain't got no
nice
money
because
you're going to run out of the money. Word. But because you got to be at work, mm-hmm. during those hours, mm-hmm. you can't spend money during those hours. You can't blow anything.
Mm-hmm. So I'd rather stay working, bro.
That's it. And
that's the key.
That's how you stay with everything.
That's how you stay rich.
Especially Buck. Right. Buck didn't wait. He put out the Before the Beast.
Straight up. It's in the streets right now.
Yeah. Is Banks next? Or, who's next? Banks, are you? The streets want to know.
We just said this earlier. The motherfucking Beast is next, March 3rd, nigga.
Listen. I don't want to see you doing this dance if you ain't got it.
Yeah.
This is not a trending thing. This is not a new thing, a fad.
Yo, I'm a, you know. Right.
Listen, if you don't, listen, when you got it, I don't care what you look like when you do it. Don't wait for the beat. Don't be on beat. Don't do nothing. Just break out.
Yo, that's killer.
That was crazy earlier, man.
But you know what's dope about the rich nigga dance?
Rich nigga
is
dance.
Is that you open up the door for a nigga that ain't got shit to come up with the broke nigga dance.
Broke nigga dance.
So the broke niggas need to pay very close attention. Right, like the broke.
That shit is in the club every
like,
night.
Seriously, like
the broke nigga dance. Broke nigga ain't dancing.
Like the broke.
Nigga mad, nigga.
Like the broke nigga dance.
Against the wall, chilling.
Nah. I tell you what happens. They come
the broke nigga dance, it's like he just exercised one finger. Like, this is the broke nigga dance right here. You just do your finger like this, and that's the trigger finger.
You are crazy, man.
Scheming. You start scheming.
We got
he can't have a good time. He can't have a good time in the beginning.
We got
then he got there and he realized that he wasn't popular. So he started looking. Like, why you got all those chains on? You ain't have to do that.
You ain't have to do that. Hilarious up here, B. We got the final question before you go, 50. Eminem, man. He won, what are you, Artist of the Year? Best rap album. Like, he's still out there killing it.
As he should, man.
All right, we're in 2015. Are you guys going to combine finally, like a Eminem 50 album?
No, well, maybe. That'd be something up to him. Em is the kind of guy that creatively has to be in that space and come up with something. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of times he'll lead with records that we make together. Twice I did it.
Mm.
Like when we did Psycho 2.
Yeah.
That was me on that one. I started, conceptually, I wrote the verse and said, Em, I want you to get on this record. Instead of letting him find, because he'll find something for me. Like he'll find a record and say, yo, I think this would be dope for you. Let me let you hear it. And I listen to it and say, I should do feel good. Like, you know what I mean? If I don't like it, I wouldn't take it. But but it'd be good. Like, he probably, best artist, best rap album. I think M got a trophy for that almost, minus one album, I think. Maybe one album, he didn't get it.
That's great.
One or two of his albums that he released didn't get it, I think. He got it a lot of times. Like, I mean, it's tough to contest it, man. He's a freak of nature.
Six albums.
Fucking ill, dog.
Wow.
Six best albums, right?
That's crazy, man.
Six best rap albums. Like, see, that shit is like a regular trophy for him.
Like, you know when motherfuckers win awards like that and don't deserve it? Like, this motherfucker really, really deserves his shit.
Yeah.
Like it ain't no fucking, man.
Shout out to Rihanna.
You see it the way I see it. Like,
this nigga's
things wouldn't even be. We wouldn't even have the shot. Right. I wouldn't have my shot.
Believe that.
The way it was supposed to be without him. Mm. You know, I love him. I love him to death, man. Like they wouldn't everything else. Because whenever I have confusion with the label, he has no idea what's going on.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So he's never involved in anything that I was disgruntled about. Mm. But he was involved with making the possibilities there. Mm. Setting it up for me, you know what I'm saying? So Em is, he'll really do no wrong to me. I don't care if he ran your kid over, I'll be still sitting there saying, nah, Em's the one, he's cool.
Damn,
well,
man.
I say he can run your kid over in broad daylight. Yeah. And I'll be like, I'll still be saying Em is my favorite.
Em mixed the first record, bro, that actually I done dealing with G.
Yeah.
Bloodhound, bro.
Yeah, he did. Wow.
M is a big part of my career with G-Unit, bro. He really, really paid attention to Buck from the very beginning.
Which On Fire, right?
He mixed On Fire. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Did he?
He mixed On Fire. On the second album.
That's what people got to understand. Like, not only do this motherfucker do what he doing on the mic, bro, but M is something special.
He a lab rat, too. Like, he had got on a production tip that was so crazy that he was like, well, he might almost make his own record.
He produced Lose Your Mind on my shit.
Yeah.
I'm about to lose your fucking mind. Mm-hmm. M produced that, bro.
Wow.
Straight up, like, M is a special motherfucker.
Yeah. You never brainstormed, like, when you're in the studio about a title for, like, I know it's, like, a long time ago, but y'all never brainstormed a title, like, you and?
I don't know. Like, you know what? I see he did an album with, what's his name?
Royce.
Royce right now. See, that's cool. M is, when people, if he creatively meshes with you, then you could do things like that. It's cool. Like, Royce been down with him for a long time.
Mm-hmm. Royce is dope, too.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
Shout out to Royce.
You understand? Royce is a fucking animal,
man. Shout out
man.
To the D.
And what's his name? What's his name? The big dude.
Joel.
No. The one I tell you, the tough one.
Who's from the D?
Yeah, he be telling you no fly zone.
Trick Trick. Shout out to Trick Trick.
Trick Trick.
Hey, yo, man, I just left the D, man. Me and Kid just left Detroit, right?
He's the illest, man.
Nah, he's beyond the illest. Shout out to Trick Trick. This is my motherfucking homeboy in real life.
This nigga daughter be wearing niggas' chains.
Man, this is my homeboy in real life, man. And I'm going to tell you
niggas
something.
Shout out to Detroit, man.
Detroit.
To they, school.
Like, Detroit want me to make sure I get people clear on this shit. So I'm going to make sure on behalf of Detroit that I get niggas real clear on this. The way y'all niggas may view me and see the way I run around Detroit, I don't advise you rap niggas to do that
you
shit.
You can't do that. Don't try this
look,
at home.
My nigga, you niggas might see my Instagram, right? And you see me and Kid running through the hood in the streets and all that shit in Detroit. It's only behind because I have real ties to this city. Like,
shout out to the real ones
real
out
way.
There, too.
But for you rappers, bro, I really, 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 and I'm keeping it 100, not just with Detroit, but a few more cities include mine. It's not safe to just come in these places and maneuver as you may feel like you can because you can't. And Detroit is one of those places you can't just come through. L.A. is one of those places you can't do it like that. New York is too. You understand? It's kind of things that, you know.
Now, I'm going to tell you the truth. It's All-Star Weekend.
Cashville, All-Star Weekend, they got a pass.
Nah, I'm telling you. Booty.
You don't have a pass.
I know specific. I know the Goonies was meeting each other.
That's what I'm saying, man. They're out there. They're robbing niggas out here.
Believe that. So it's like.
We'll do the count after.
We'll do the count after. Straight
we'll do
up.
The count after.
Shout out to my homeboys out there on the West, man.
Oh, my God.
Y'all be careful now. Shout wear out your seatbelt out on these streets.
Shout out to Nipsey, man. What up?
So you gotta be safe out there.
You got to give him an invoice 50 for coming today? For, you know, he's up
what?
Here. You know, your man is
Wait,
up here.
Let me tell you something.
before you go, 50.
When the last time y'all seen Eminem, man? Shit is called Shade 45, man.
Yo, man, I feel like crashing. Hey, yo, 50.
When is the last time you saw Eminem, man?
It's what been a the minute. Fuck?
Real quick,
that's
man.
How they, that's how they get him on the radio.
What the fuck?
Woo! What the fuck?
March 3rd, man. Shout out the album drop, 5th, before you go.
Yeah, man. The Beast will be out. Yeah. March 3rd is going down. Y'all can check it out.
When is the next leak? When is the first song from there going to be leaked?
Well, the first song off of the Beast is Bottle.
So what's next after that?
It's Young Buck, huh?
What are you going to leak next? You want to shout that out, or is you going to keep it?
Yeah, I got a few. It's a few pieces on there, but they should look forward to hearing a joint called I'm Grown.
Okay.
Because I do what the fuck I want.
I'm grown.
I got
I'm
my grown. Own house.
Yeah, I like this.
That shit is crazy, too.
Jesus Christ. Yayo and Kid, shout out what your plans are before you go.
El Chapo coming. Whenever it's time, Beast coming next, Cold Corner coming, Street Fame coming.
Street
niggas
Fame
working,
is coming,
man.
I'm going to drop Fuck the Fame before Street Fame.
Oh, Fuck
though.
The Fame?
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, man, I might do that like real shortly right after the Beast drop. You know what I'm saying? I got this crazy record, man, I'm going to release, man.
I'm going to let kids start putting his tapes out. You know what I was doing for a long time? I've been holding back. I've been holding back because, look, you got so many records recorded. It's ridiculous. Like, probably more than every single one of us here, because the entire time he's recording, in the recording process, until you find a groove, and then it starts to feel different when we all work together, and then his production choice changes. So now he's starting to pick things that's it's even iller, the music that he's creating now. And I'm looking to go, boom, just let him keep working until he sees and get himself into where you... If you get a shot too early,
right,
it's a nightmare for an artist.
Yep.
He gonna have one. You see what I'm saying? Like, you can't make another record to follow up behind that record that you put out. Wow. Like, I went through a process with Jam Master Jay where I made music. I had a song. I felt like it was a hit. Right. He produced the record. He enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed it. And we played it, and then we played it, and then we played it. And he was like, listen, if that shit is what we think it is, you need another one.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Rest in peace.
Turn that off. Let's go to the new stuff. and we went to work making music all over again. And that was a big lesson in that, man, because it taught me not to fall in love with the music, and let's work and make the best possible music we can to create an impression on the period. You know what I mean? And then
wow.
when you do that and you gather up, you're not going to have a weekend. I did it once. One time. I was so in pocket during the massacre. The first time I went to write The Massacre. Shit.
So now I know where they came from.
What I'm telling you is creatively, I was in a place where anything that I'm saying, anything I think is what's supposed to be played right now on the radio. So it's like, that's when the first, I did 12 joints throughout 3 days in the weekend. There was all two verse records. So it was a chorus, verse, and then go back to clean them up to make it, you know, all the way right. But those songs turned out to be special, higher.
I remember that. I remember hated playing love that it. On the condo balcony. I
was like, yeah, how we do. It wow, turned into to Games album. What's up in this guy? And then I went back to rewrite the first time, as I was writing everything without writing any sexual stuff.
Wow.
And then I went back and wrote Candy Shop just a little bit. You know what I mean? Came the other way.
Right.
Wow.
Because I gave him those records, and it was like hit records without talking about any sexual energy or anything like that. I went back to do mines with the singles off the album, like that they were sexual a little more.
Speaking of sexual, Banks, did you pass 4,000 bitches yet?
That's about my bars or something.
What
you talking about?
I listen to your
bars. What you talking about?
Hey, yo, who cares?
y'all gave me.
I fucked 3,000. I don't know. I fucked 3,000. I don't know.
Since when? You broke up, nigga?
Yo, who cares? Every time I see your
Instagram, this nigga still live like a fucking platinum rapper.
Every time I see your Instagram, who cares?
This nigga got Asian bitches.
You got like 30, 40 bitches.
I can't believe I don't have AIDS.
That's it. You got Asian and white bitches.
I ain't lying, like you fucked up, bro.
Why you still living really like that?
Dip, nigga. I line niggas. I do my homework, I find niggas. The niggas that did that, they my niggas.